The recent release of Active Presenter 9 has presented a brand new interactive object, Dropdown. With this object, you can now conserve screen space and let users interact with the dropdown conveniently. I'm Clay, and in today's video, together, let's find out how to create a dropdown menu in Active Presenter 9 with only 6 quick steps. Step 1. Insert dropdowns. Click the drop-down button from the Insert tab. The cursor then turns into a crosshair. So, click or drag the mouse on the canvas to insert. A default drop-down is a single select list box with two main parts, text box and drop-down arrow button. Step 2. Add item list to drop-down. In the Properties pane, Interactivity tab, drop-down section, you can customize hint item, item list, and variable. First, add item list. Click here to add new items to the list. Type a text or value in the item column. Then, freely edit, delete, or rearrange them using commands above the item list. Next, set correct values. In the item list created earlier, simply tick the corresponding checkbox to set the correct value and untick it to remove. Then, let's move on to change the hint item. Hint item allows you to click on it to review an item list. Its default text is select. You can change it by selecting a checkbox in the default column of the item list or uncheck it and type a new text in the hint item text box. Now, add variables to the dropdown. Variables can be used sometimes when one item refers to a specific object. If you need one, click here. Type a name for the variable and click OK to add. Step 3. Set score and reporting. This section provides you with many options to set the score and report to evaluate your learners in survey or graded mode. Set points. Set maximum times learners can try. Set the time limit. And the way they can submit the answer. Step 4. Work with drop-down states. The states of a drop-down show how it looks when it works with two default states, normal and disabled. You can add more states if you want. Step 5. To make a dropdown work or any object work, you need to add events and actions to it. Navigate to the Properties pane, Interactivity tab. Then add events and actions that you want. For example, I choose the onCorrect event here. Then play audio. This means that the backtrack will be played if I choose the right answer for the dropdown like this. Step 6. Style dropdowns. Finally, style your dropdowns easily in the Format tab. You can choose a style for the dropdown in the dropdown styles gallery. Or customize the color, background, arrow, and border with the suggested options here. That's it! You can get access to the written tutorial in the description box now for more details. And it's time to design your own dropdown. Don't forget to give us a like, share, and comment your thoughts below. We will be back with more tutorials. See you later!